Let's now consider the concept of the effective rate of trade protection. The key point here is that the numerical tariff does not directly measure how much protection domestic producers receive. You can think of the concept of an effective rate of protection as the percentage change in value added following a tariff. And this percentage change in value added can be higher than, less than, or equal to the numerical size of the tariff. So let's take an example. Say, for instance, that automobiles are selling for $8,000, they are produced for $6,000, and that will mean per automobile a value added of $2,000. Now we're going to add a tariff on automobiles coming in from foreign nations, and the size of that tariff will be 25% of the price of the automobile sold. And now we can calculate the effective rate of protection. The price of cars is going from $8,000 to $10,000, and that's assuming competitive conditions. We then find that the new value added is $10,000 minus the cost of production, $6,000, and that gives us $4,000. So the value added has gone from $2,000 to $4,000, and that is up 100%. So in this example, the rate of effective protection is 100%, and that is higher than the rate of the tariff, which was 25%. Note that a high effective rate of protection does not overturn the traditional economic case for free trade. The effective rate of protection is simply looking at how much more surplus is going to producers, and of course the case for free trade has a lot to do with the gains for consumers as well. For instance, a higher price for cars will mean fewer cars sold, and that will make consumers generally worse off. The simplest way to think about a negative rate of effective protection is to think about tariffs on inputs. So say a country puts tariffs on computers. Well, computers help produce a lot of goods and services. It could be the case that producer surplus is falling after the tariff is put on consumers, and that would be a negative rate of effective protection. Because tariffs on useful inputs lower the rate of effective protection, that means that the rate of effective protection generally is lower when there are long supply chains and tariffs applied at various points along that chain. Also, it is generally true that the rate of effective protection will be higher when the tariffs are applied only to final outputs and not to any of the inputs in a production process for a country. Anyway, those are just some of the basics of the concept of an effective rate of protection. If you'd like to read more about it, including seeing some formulas for how to actually compute the rate of effective protection more generally, we advise Googling using these keywords.